Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell button to be notified as soon as I post a new video.
Hi guys, Ishpreet here. Welcome back to Slick and Natty. Some time back, I had made a video on a DIY backpack from old denims or old jeans, and you all had given a great response to that video. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make another type of DIY backpack. This one is a drawstring bag, which is extremely simple to make, and at the same time it looks very stylish and is very versatile. You can use it as a college bag, as a picnic bag, as a grocery shopping bag, or if you're a mother who has kids, you can use it as a diaper bag. Basically, you can use it for multiple purposes. And this bag you can make from any leftover fabric pieces that you might have lying at home, or you can even use fabric from your old kurtis or kurtas or old maxi gowns. And if you don't have any fabric piece lying at home, then you can even buy it from the market, which will not cost you much. So let's start.
This is the piece of cloth that I had lying at my home, which I'll be using to make the drawstring bag today. Your cloth piece should be about 44 inches along the longer side and 19 inches along the shorter side. You can use a smaller piece of fabric as well in the same proportions if you want a smaller bag. Before we proceed further, we will cut a 2 inch wide strip from one of the shorter sides and keep it aside for the moment. Now turn your fabric piece around so that its wrong side is facing upwards. Next, we will fold the long side by about half an inch like this, and fold it one more time again by about half an inch and secure it in place with the help of all pins. Do this all along this side like I have done here, as well as along the other long side of the fabric piece. Don't stitch on it for the time being, we'll do that later on. Now coming to the shorter side of our fabric piece, fold this by about 1 inch like this, and then cut the corners at an angle like I am doing here. Do this for both the corners and then fold the shorter side by 1 inch one more time. We had cut the corners at an angle because that will help to keep the corners clean. Repeat these same steps on the other short side of the fabric piece. And after doing this, we will stitch on this very close to the edge. Here we are basically creating a sleeve for the cord of the bag that we will be inserting later on. So here I have stitched on both the short sides and the stitch is close to the edge, as you can see. Okay, now coming to the strip which we had cut from our fabric piece in the beginning. First of all, turn the strip around so that its wrong side is facing upwards. Then fold its two long sides to bring these to the middle like this. And then fold it into half like I am doing here. And then give a straight stitch over it. So here you can see that our strip is ready. We will now cut two smaller strips from it, each about 5 inches long. And then we have to make loops like this from both these strips. Now take the fabric piece which we had stitched on both the short sides but not stitched on the long sides yet, and turn it around so that its right side is facing upwards this time, and then fold it into half like this so that the two short sides are exactly on top of each other. Now take one of the loops that we just made and insert it into the fold here. While inserting this into the fold, make sure that its loose ends are sticking out while the loop part is inside, like this. Pin this loop in place with the help of an all pin. Take the other loop that we had made and insert it into the other side of the folded edge in exactly the same way and pin it in place as well. Next, we have to give a straight stitch on both these sides, starting from the loop till the seam of the shorter side. So here you can see that I have stitched from the loop till the stitch on the shorter side. Your stitch should not go beyond the seam. So like this, I have stitched on both the sides. Okay, so this bag is now closed from three sides except this top side, which is open. Using this open side, turn the bag around to bring its right side out. The loops that we had inserted into the fold will now look like this. Next, you will need a cord like this. You will require about 3.5 meters of this. I am here using the string that we use in our salwars and petticoats. You can even use a rope of any color of your choice. To determine the required length of the cord, just lay the cord in L shape along the two sides of the back and then double it up. This is the length that you require, so cut it. We need another rope piece of exactly the same length. So repeat these steps and cut another string as well. So here we've got two cord strings of exactly the same length that we'll be inserting into the top edge of our bag. I'll just rotate the bag so that the top edge is facing me. We now have to pull these cords through the sleeves at the top of the bag in opposite directions like I have placed these here. So take one of the cords and attach safety pin to one of its ends and then push it through this hole of the sleeve on the top edge of the bag. Keep pushing it and pulling the fabric back so that it keeps moving forward. And when it comes out of the other end, like this, then you put it into the hole of the other sleeve. And keep pushing it forward like before, till it comes out of the other end. Pull this out a little more, and then take one of these strings and pass it through the loop at the bottom of the bag, like this. And then tie the two strings together with a double knot. And trim off the excess rope. So here one side of the bag is ready and now we will repeat these steps with the other string. The only difference is that we will pass it in the opposite direction so that it comes out of the other end. Pass this one also through the loop and tie a knot just like we had done before and your drawstring bag is ready. I hope that you like this video. Do subscribe to my channel for more such videos and connect with me on my Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter accounts. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.